الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده، أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، أوصيكم أولا ونفسي بتقوى الله فقد فاز المتقون. قال تعالى في كتابه: ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: من حج ولم يفسق رجع كيوم ولدته امه، او كما قال عليه الصلاه والسلام. الحمد لله، all praise and thanks due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Peace and salawat upon our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear respected brothers and elders in Islam, firstly I would like to advise myself and those who are present: ittaqillaha ta'ala haythuma kuntum, fi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at all times, at all moments. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah has gathered us in one of the most honorable months in the months of Islamic, in the Islamic calendar, which is the month of Dhul-Qa'dah. My dear brothers in Islam, a month where millions of people all over the world traveling to fulfill the order of Allah, obeying the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from all over the world for one reason: to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah has said in the Quran: وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. And for Allah, those whom Allah has given strength, ability, they should perform the ritual of Hajj, the ibadah of Hajj, lillah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today in the world, there are so many gatherings are taking place. So many cities are modernized, and the cities have become places of entertainment, places of enjoyment, places of luxury and comfort. One nation boasts, we are the heart of Asia. Another nation boasts, we are that, we are this, we have the best of best beaches, we have the best street, and etc., etc. My dear brothers in Islam, they all are hunting people to their own land or welcoming them under the slogan of tourism. But let us look, the Baytullah, the house of Allah, which was placed, the very first house of Allah which was placed on this planet: inna awwala baytin wudi'a lin-nasi lalladhi bi-Bakkah mubarakah, which is in Makkah al-Mukarramah. All these people, millions of people, are traveling from all around the globe and the universe, my dear brothers in Islam, for what? To fulfill the one order of Allah, to fulfill the one obligation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is a miracle by itself. 21st century, the modern time, many things have changed, ideologies have changed, lifestyle have changed. But my dear brothers in Islam, every person of Iman, he wishes every day in his heart that my Allah should give me the opportunity. Those who have been, they are wishing they must go again and again before they meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That itself is a miracle. It is a miracle for you and me to believe that the rububiyah in the heart of a person of Iman, that we have accepted Allah as our Rabb. He is alone, and for Him that people are traveling all around the world. That these gathering of Hajj,
had become world's largest gathering, even though so many gatherings are available for sports, for entertainment, for leisure and for luxury. But my dear brothers in Islam, only to please Allah, all these people are traveling across the globe. What is their dhikr? What are they saying? Subhanallah, my dear brothers in Islam, labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, innal hamda wal ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. Oh my master, I am at your service. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik. Oh my Rabb, you are my Rabb and I am at your service. Subhanallah, there is no partners unto you, ya Allah, and all praises and all the bounties that you have given me, because it is a ibadah. A person contributes physically, financially, both that he contributes to fulfill the order, fulfill the ibadah of Hajj. My dear brothers in Islam, let us go back. What is the wisdom, what is the lesson that we derive from this great ibadah of Hajj? Let us understand, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Nabiuna Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam, وَإِذْ بَوَّأَنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ أَلَّا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا وَطَنِّرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْقَائِمِينَ وَالرُّكَّعِ السُّجُودِ. Allah ordered Nabiuna Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam with his son Ismail to build this house of Allah in order people to come and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers in Islam, Allah said, Allah ordered, build this. That was the order which came to Nabiuna Ibrahim. And my dear brothers in Islam, Quran continues, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعْ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْكَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلِ. And when they completed the structure with clay and stones and rocks or whatever, but my dear brothers in Islam, they raised their hands towards Allah. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. Oh Allah, you ordered us, you wanted us to do this contribution for your deen. We have done. Oh Allah, accept this from us. Oh Allah, accept this from us. My dear brothers in Islam, let us understand, it was this family of Nabiuna Ibrahim. He was taken out of his own family. He was expelled from his city. He was distanced from his parents. My dear brothers in Islam, for what purpose? لِإِعْلَاءِ كَلِمَةِ اللَّهِ. The word of Allah, the word of Allah should remain untaught. The word of Allah should be protected and preserved. And that was the contribution of Nabiuna Ibrahim, his son Ismail, later his wives. My dear brothers in Islam, all of them, the journey of Hajj gives this message. Most of the rituals, when you study, my dear brothers in Islam, they were done by Nabiuna Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam by themselves. Later, it became part of our Sharia by the teachings of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. My dear brothers in Islam, they made all these contributions. This entire one family made this entire contribution in order that this deen should remain in this place, because that their dua, my dear brothers in Islam, when they completed, the first thing they said, ya Allah, we have done what you have ordered us, now accept this good action from us, accept this contribution from us. And further they said, Rabbana waja'alna muslimaini lak wa min dhurriyyatihim dhurriyyatina ummatan muslimatan lak wa arina manasikana wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Then they said, oh Allah, make us people who have subjugated ourselves, who have submitted ourselves for your worship, for your oneness, ya Allah. And further they said, my dear brothers in Islam, oh Allah, guide from our progeny, from our ummah, guide from our progeny, a group of people who will worship you, who will obey you, who will submit their will, their fancy, their desire in your pleasure, ya Allah. My dear brothers in Islam, that was the dua of Nabiuna Ibrahim. The impact is seen today by you and me. My dear brothers in Islam, today the millions of people going, we need to understand, my dear brothers in Islam, when Allah ordered after completion to Nabiuna Ibrahim, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ. O Ibrahim, give the alan, give the announcement, call out to the people to visit this holy house of Allah. My dear brothers in Islam, it comes in a narration in Bayhaqi that Nabiuna Ibrahim said, Ya Allah, Kaifa, how can I do this? How can I call the people that how, even though that I call out to the people, how can my message reach the people? My dear brothers in Islam, Allah ordered, Azdin wa alayya al-ibalagh. O Ibrahim, you give the announcement, you give the invitation, it is upon us to convey this message, ila qiyamis sa'a, till the qiyamis, till the day of qiyamah. My dear brothers in Islam, those who heard the invitation of Nabiuna Ibrahim, my dear brothers in Islam, they will definitely in their lifetime will answer by saying in front of the house of Allah, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik. My dear brothers in Islam, let us understand it is a golden contribution done by one complete family. They did, they sacrificed everything what they have. Allah gave them a city better than their city. Allah gave them a house. Allah made them to build a house better than the house that they lived with their father Azar. And Allah gave a progeny and a family where the origin of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam comes from there. My dear brothers in Islam, and many Anbiya. My dear brothers in Islam, what is your and my contribution to the deen of Allah? Let us ask, we go back to the history. It is a lesson to you and me. The entire lesson of Hajj is telling you and me that you and your and my contribution is demanded to keep the kalimatullah, the word of Allah, to be kept on top. My dear respected brothers, elders in Islam, let us ask ourselves, what is my contribution? What have I done in my life? What good that I have done? What Nabiuna Ibrahim had and what he did? My dear brothers in Islam, the lesson to you and me, we as people of Iman must do our best. And my dear brothers in Islam, Allah will convey the balance. Allah will do the balance. But do we do that? Do we have taken? Are we making an effort, my dear brothers in Islam? Let us understand. Let us go back to the annals of our history. Our predecessors, our A'imma, the Sahaba, my dear brothers in Islam, in the Battle of Uhud, that when Muslims were attacked, the arrows were coming towards sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Here one Sahabi saw this, he ran and he became a shield in front of Rasulullah, and he died in front of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because arrows were hitting him from all corners. It was that day, the need was that Sahabi to be a shield to defend Allah and his Rasul. There he contributed his life. Then the time of Tabi'i, where the hadith was preserved, the deen was preserved, Islam spread across the globe. Islam reached Africa, Islam reached Europe, Islam reached many parts of the world, Islam reached China. That was the contribution they did, because that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, لِتَكُونَ كَلِمَةُ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْعُلْيَا, the word of Allah to be on top. All contributions were done. My dear brothers in Islam, let us understand that then the time of the fuqaha, my dear brothers in Islam, a time after Tabi'i, the time of Tabi'ut Tabi'i and etc. Let us understand the contribution of the fuqaha. At that time, people were in confusion, because that people started following things the way they see and they looked at it. They did not understand the jurisprudence and the depth of Quran and Sunnah, the contribution of the fuqaha. One of the historians write that if there was no Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah, in his opinion, many part of this deen would have removed from this mankind. My dear brothers in Islam, one day Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah making imamat as an imam and he broke his salah. His student asked him, my dear brothers in Islam, oh my teacher, why did you break your salah? He said, oh my son, for last 3 days I had no food to eat. I couldn't bear, I couldn't control myself. My dear brothers in Islam, let us go down to the time of the Muhaddithun. All the 6 authentic books of hadith were compiled in this era, in this generation, in that time period. Out of 6 books of hadith, only 1 is an Arab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the balance 5, all Imam Bukhari, Tirmidhi, Abu Dawud, Ibn Majah, An-Nasai, and etc. Allah used all of them from other background, from other environment, not from the Arab Peninsula. It was Muslim, rahimahullah, who compiled the Muslim Sharif from an Arab background. They made their contribution. And my dear brothers in Islam, the time does not permit to detail the contribution of these great legends in Islam. Let us understand, it was the life of Imamun al-Bukhari, rahimahullah. My dear brothers in Islam, when we study the chain of Imamun al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, it is a surprise that one of his great-great-grandfathers were fire worshippers. Let us understand, he hails from a very simple family, my dear brothers in Islam, from the lands of Russia or from the Russian continent. Let us understand, here he hails and he travels across the globe because he saw it was the time where the hadith of Rasul is being fabricated. My dear brothers in Islam, here Imamun al-Bukhari rahimahullah comes from a very simple background and he makes the greatest contribution to this mankind. My dear brothers in Islam, and that Allama Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he narrates about the life of Imamun al-Bukhari rahimahullah. He says Imamun al-Bukhari studied under 1,000 mashayikh, 1,000 ulama, 1,000 muhaddithun, or the tabi'i, the a'imma who lived at that time. Imamun al-Bukhari traveled and he learned the hadith from them. And he taught to 70,000 students. My dear brothers in Islam, one person says, I spent one night in the company of Imamun al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Every night, 20 times he will wake up. Suddenly he will wake up and he will rush, take his books, start writing and protecting and compiling the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It was asked, why that at night you cannot have a peaceful sleep? He conveys, my dear brothers in Islam, I am fearing the enemies of Islam will fabricate and lead this mankind astray with the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. My dear brothers in Islam, let us see that it was one day Imamun al-Bukhari studied. The students are waiting till Imamun al-Bukhari come. He did not come first day, second day, third day. They went and asked. When they went to the house of Imamun al-Bukhari, he did not have a cloth. The dress that he was wearing had torn and he did not have a proper dress. My dear brothers in Islam, this was the contribution of the legends of Islam to protect Islam. Today, Asahul Kutub Ba'd al-Quran, the most authentic book after Quran, compiled by a person of Russia or from that continent. Let us understand that what is my contribution today? We live in this country. We have lived in this country, my dear brothers in Islam. We have to see where the Muslim Ummah is deteriorating, falling apart, that Muslims are being pinpointed. Let us see that what contribution that I could do, what support that I could do, in order Allah, word of Allah is honored and valued, my dear brothers in Islam. Let us take the youth of today. What contribution we as a society doing to empower them, to guide them? Is their education standard is properly maintained? so much of international schools in the name of Islam or whatever, but we need to ask that is the right contribution is done by them, or how to strengthen them, how to support them, my dear brothers in Islam. We need to understand, see from all avenue our masajid, how to protect, how to take care of them, how to maintain them, the ilm, the ulama, the madaris, what is the contribution that I could do, what is the support that I could do, that I had done a contribution in my life before that I meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers in Islam, a hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that man sanna sunnatan hasana falahu ajruha wa ajru man amila biha min ghayri an yanqusa min ujurihim shay'a. My dear brothers in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that person who establishes a good system in a society, a good thing in a society, a good teaching in a society, so many needs, that so much of talaq problems in our society, so much of anti-Islamic slogans in our society, so many things are being neglected, we claim that we have done something, let us make an effort, we should not become people to pass the ball that they must do, or all Ceylon Jama'iyatul Ulama should do. Ulama should do. Responsibility upon all of us, and each one of us must do our contribution in order Islam remains intact in our society, to our progenies till the day of Qiyamah and in this land. Let us take the lesson of the contribution of a family of Nabiuna Ibrahim, that we, our family, our children, let us do our best financially, physically, mentally, with our skills what Allah has given. Let us do something to protect and beautify Islam to the mankind, in order they will understand the light of Islam and the door will be open for them as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq, accept us, use us.